Being an entrepreneur is a bug. It's an affliction I always had in my life. I was born in Athens. My family, there's an extended family that is very close. And the reason this is particularly important for me is that that extended family has had a very important influence in what I've done in my life. In Athens, where we were living during the 4 years of occupation of Greece, I spent all my time in the library to learn more about who is this guy, Thomas Edison, that all my uncles said that I may be the next Thomas Edison. You have to understand that in Greece, in 1942, there was tremendous hunger. There were dead people found in the streets, dead from hunger mostly. There was also a lot of activity against the Nazis. I decided to do something that was very clearly punishable by death. There was a tremendous demand to hear news from the outside world. So I came up with the idea of building a radio, a shortwave radio, to hear BBC. And in the junkyard, there was piles of old stuff. I would find vacuum tubes there, bring them back to my lab, the Germans were upstairs, and make radios. And that was my first enterprise. It was very dangerous, but it was very successful. You see, you shouldn't lose sight of your purpose. What is your purpose? I want to build a company that is at least as good as the company that Thomas Edison did. The first thing that led to MIT was when I decided what country I wanted to build that company. When I wanted to pick my thesis, what I want to do is to work in preparing for my creation of my company based on my inventions. The invention that I came up with for that company is to convert heat into electricity by boiling off electrons. For the first time, MIT used its own money to support my thesis. MIT should be considered as co-founder of Thermo Electron. The support they gave me was unbelievable. Unbelievable. All these MIT people that came to it, they believed in what we were doing. They believed in the whole idea of serving society by finding ways to solve problems. I turned the pages of the New York Times and found that the disease that killed more Americans every year is heart problems. I decided right there, that's our next business. We're gonna make an artificial heart. When I retired, we had built 23 companies, very successful companies. You know, my board kept asking me, the company is doing very well and you're working very hard. Why, on top of it, you have to teach at MIT? But I like teaching. I have fun teaching. I really mean that. They paid me to teach at MIT, and every year I would donate all that pay back to MIT. You learn a subject more by teaching it than anything else, especially if you teach kids that ask the most unheard of questions that floor you. I did not do it because it was useful. I did it because it was fun. That's my goal. 80% fun. And I've achieved it over time many times. useful to set a certain direction you want to go. After you set the direction, don't focus in your goal. Focus in enjoying the ride.